Thank you, Council President Katz, and thank you to Christine Wellens, who worked hard on this, Aaron Kraut in my office, and co-sponsors Councilmembers Glass and Juwando. This is something I've been focused on since my second full day in office, almost exactly a year ago, when I led a group of stakeholders on a walking tour of downtown Bethesda, specifically focused on pedestrian safety and the livable, walkable, accessible communities we frequently talk about. One of the frequent challenges is the number of sidewalks that are closed and closed for long periods of time. This legislation will clarify and codify our expectation that pedestrian access must be maintained as a default and that we view sidewalks not as a luxury, but as an essential part of our transportation infrastructure. As we have an urbanizing county and urbanizing community, we need to treat our neighborhoods in an urban way, which means that a lot of people walk, and those access points to walk need to be safe and they need to be accessible. We rarely allow part of a county roadway to be taken for a year or more to accommodate a construction project, and we shouldn't allow that to happen for a sidewalk. This is about safety, it's about quality of life, and it's about the changing nature of our county and our community. Specifically, this bill would require the executive to draft regulation for permits to close sidewalks that limit the closure to the necessary to the time necessary, require regular review by permitting services and other county government officials involved to determine if a permittee must immediately reopen the sidewalk or begin providing an alternative path on the same side of the street, including a covered walkway or protected pathway in a parking lane or curb lane, specify the standards that must be met to demonstrate that a sidewalk can't be open or provide alternative access because of an extreme hardship, and require the county to publish permit applications and permits online so that they can be readily seen by retailers, by residents, and by other stakeholders involved. It's important to note that this would not apply to the right-of-way along state highways, such as Wisconsin Avenue, though Delegate Corman and other members of our District 16 and District 18 delegations and other members of the General Assembly are working on those issues as we speak, and we continue to work with them to resolve some of the state issues. But our permitting services officials, Department of Transportation officials, Bethesda Urban Partnership, and others have really made great progress on many of these issues on a case-by-case basis, but it's long overdue that we have a systematic approach and a way that is clear and consistent and transparent for residents to understand when and for how long a sidewalk would be closed, and make sure that our urban communities in Montgomery County, which are increasing, and the number of people who are living there and working there are increasing, are maintained as walkable, accessible, and as safe as possible. Thank you.